Hi, I'm Natalie Morris, formerly Natalie Del Conte. Thank you for watching my demo reel. 3, 2. Like Janet Jackson. Test, test, test. What? The best. It's Monday, January 10th. I'm Natalie Morris, and it's time to get loaded. The 2011 Consumer Electronics Show has just wrapped here in Las Vegas, and here's one thing Google will not remove with the kill switch: iBoobs. This is a rather juvenile but also pretty comical app that lets you jiggle a pair of boobs up and down. The app costs $2, but there's also a free version called iBoobs Lite. I think there are fewer features on this free version, not smaller boobs, but I didn't test to verify that. If we've said it once, we've said it a million times, stop that. It's really important. What it does is filter out all offensive content on YouTube. That includes pornography, nudity, graphic violence, narcotics. Those are the kind of things that should be taken off YouTube anyway, but since there's so much on YouTube, YouTube can't police it. So now at least it will be filtered for age-appropriate viewing. What it's doing now is parading as an antivirus program called Spyware Protect 2009. It takes users to a fake website, asks them to pay $50 for a spyware program that actually is Conficker, and then it keeps your credit card information, it infects your computer, and it keeps that $50. Hi, I'm Natalie Morris for CNET. You're watching our coverage of the 2011 Consumer Electronics Show, and I am wearing the Empower lenses. These are the world's first auto-focusing prescription lenses. Now, when they're in auto mode, they've got this accelerometer here in the temple that notices when I look down to read something, it's going to focus. When I look back up, it's going to come off of that focus that would be ideal for reading. An extension cord, so if you want to wear it on your waist, say clip it to your Speedo. Now, if you wanted this to float for some reason, say you were canoeing, you could put on this little floaty. It's like a life preserver for your MP3. So I'm gonna drop it in this water bowl and we'll put it to the test here. Here we go. Anchors away. And finally, we know you love your digital camera, but do you love it enough to implant it into your head? An NYU professor is going to do just that. Okay, I can see the merit of something like this. It's avant-garde and interesting, but how do you charge that thing? For more information about me, go to nataliemorris.com. Thank you for watching.